Hello viewers, welcome to RK Keynotes. In the statistics for data science model, today we are going to explore correlation. Basically, correlation is to determine relationship between two variables. It is a statistical measure that expresses the extent to which two variables are linearly related. Consider an example of body mass index calculation. So you need to provide an input of your height and weight so that the calculation will be done and we'll be getting an answer that is about obesity and all. So it depends on the variables, right? That is height and weight. So likewise, we can consider one more example. The resale value of a bike depends on how much kilometer it ran and the year of manufacturing and all, right? So it is also depending on the variables. So we're going to explore few things in this session. And the correlation values lies between minus 1 and 1. If it is 0, then there is no correlation. So these are all the examples. Like if a graph is like this, then there is no correlation. And towards left, this is called positive correlation. So this is a perfect positive correlation. And this is highly positive correlation. And these, you know, dots are not closely related. So which means that a low positive correlation. And here there is nothing, so that's why it is no correlation, because it is the value is zero. And when you go to the negative things, then if the line falls like this, then it is low negative correlation. Then this is, if it falls like this, then high negative correlation. Then this is perfect negative correlation, just opposite to perfect positive correlation. Hope you understood this. And we are going to use NumPy library in this. We are going to do some array operations, and basically NumPy are used to do these kind of operations like array. If you are doing multidimensional array operations and matrices, we'll be using NumPy for numerical calculations and all. And we are going to explore seaborn library. Basically, this is similar to matplotlib, and this seaborn is a library that uses matplotlib underneath to plot graphs. We are going to plot heat map using this correlation concept. So that is why we are going to use these two libraries. And both seaborn and matplotlib are used to visualize the distribution of data and the variables. Let's flip to Google Colab for the practical demo. So these are all my libraries. I'm going to import first of all pandas and numpy. And I'm going to use a data set called correlation. The link is given in the description box. You can download this. And I'm going to read this one into a variable called data. And this is fine. Now I'm going to display the top 5 records. So these are all our records, like item identifier, item weight, item MRP, and item outlet sales. I'm going to use a function called cor, C-O-R-R, that is correlation. So now I just want to find a correlation for these two things, like item weight and item MRP. So the data set got stored in a variable called data, and within that I'm passing a list. So with the function called cor, just I'm going to run this cell, and if you see this, this is our answer, but it is like 0.027, so which means that this is not properly related, right? Basically, correlation in the sense it lies between minus 1 and 1. We said that if it is 0, then it is not correlated. That is what we have seen. So now let's find the correlation between the item weight and item outlet sales. Just pass the column names here using correlation function. We can find the correlation. Now again, the value is not that much good. It is 0.014, so which is not okay. And let's find the correlation between item MRP and item outlet sales. Run this one. If you see this, there is a change in the value. It is 0.56, which means that it is towards 1. I mean, nearly near to 1. So this is fine. And now, if you see this. We're going to import seaborn library. that is import matplotlib.pyplot. We have already used in previous sessions, and I'm going to use inline because I'm going to use this within Google Colab, and import cbon as SNS. So just import these libraries, and this is just a warning, no issue. And over here I'm going to use a dataset dot core, which means that it will automatically correlate the whole data set, but it won't display. See, here it is item weight, item MRP, and item outlet is there. It is not displaying item identifier. Why? So item identifier is not a numeric value, it comes under categorical value. So this correlation can be done only for the numeric values. All right, let's check again. If you see this ABC DR, so these things are, you know, are unable to read, so it can read only the numeric values. All right, so now our correlation table got plotted. Now let's generate a heat map to visualize these things in more clear way. So for that I'm having a variable called core. So this data.core got passed into this variable, and I'm going to plot a figure. This is the size. You can play with the size, like you can change the size, and using cbon SNS dot, I'm going to generate a heat map for this core. I'm going to pass this for this data set actually. Run the cell. So this is the heat map. Heat map uses color codes, which gives you the insights of the data on how it is correlated with the variables. If you see that there is item weight and item outlet cell, it is not correlated properly, and but this item MRP and item outlet cell, so both uses the same color, right? So these things are correlated. If you see this item MRP and item outlet cell, these things are correlated nicely. And that's it. Hope you like this video. Try this one and let me know in the comment section. Thank you.